Hi guys, it's Gabby. So today I am going to be doing a DIY mirror transformation. So I'm actually so excited for this because today we are going to be DIYing this mirror that I have right here. It's in my room. All of my other mirrors are just regular, you know, mirrors. This one's a little bit this one's a little bit more creative, and I actually love it. I love the style of it. I love the little flower situation going on right here. I think it's actually a beautiful mirror. The only problem with it is that it just doesn't match my room. The theme of my room is basically this lamp right here, white, dark purple, dark purple, white, dark blue, light blue, and purple. So as you guys can see, white, dark blue, light blue, purple. And it just doesn't match. The purple does, however, the pink does not. So what I think I want to do, also, this is what it looks like closed for anyone wondering. The hinge did actually break. So yeah, so I told my dad that I wanted to DIY it, and he told me that we could do it. And yeah, so basically my idea for this is the purple does match my room. So I think what I want to do first is just make the pink white and see how it looks just like that, because I like the gold hardware, I like the purple, but I want to see what it looks like with just the pink white and like the pink on the inside as well. If I like it but like not enough, I want to do just the entire thing white. I think that'll look really dope and kind of just make my room a lot more cleaner. But yeah, so this is kind of the mirror. It's a pretty nice mirror and I'd like to take pictures in it, but once again, it's just not the color that I really desire or want. And so I thought it'd be a cute and fun transformation, a cute video idea, and also really something to do during quarantine since I'm kind of bored. But yeah, so I think that's what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna, you know, explain to you guys what I'm doing. You'll obviously see the before and after if I do the all white or just the some of it white. And yeah, so that's kind of the vibes for the video today. I really hope that you guys enjoy and keep on watching. The first step of this transformation process was to obviously remove the mirror from my wall, which is what my dad is doing, and he actually did the first few steps of this transformation. He also removed all of the gold handles so that way we could take all of the pieces apart in order to paint them. Right here you can see him taking some tape so that the purple didn't get painted on. In this step I didn't know whether I wanted to keep the purple or paint it a different color, so as you guys can see, we are basically getting rid of the purple completely so that way when we paint the pink part white, it doesn't get messed up. So we wanted to make sure that this was thoroughly done.
Guys, so we just finished taping up all the purple so that it doesn't get messed up. So I'm just gonna tape up some right here.
Similar to the other parts of the mirror, we also had to protect this side as well so that we didn't get paint onto the mirror itself. However, this is where we made our mistake because the cardboard accidentally lifted the mirror and ended up cracking it. So I would suggest using something lighter such as paper, and then we began the painting process. My dad just did two layers, so this is what it looks like. A lot better. So I'm gonna do a third right now. In my garage right now, this is the update on my mirror. It looks amazing. However, we came into a little bit of an issue. As I put in my video earlier, the mirror ripped. I don't know if you guys can see that. Yeah, you guys can. It's a huge rip on my mirror. Crack, my bad. Crack in the mirror. It sucks because I love this mirror, but my dad is going to try to find one to replace the one in this because I don't want to throw this mirror away. It's kind of why I repurposed it. But yeah, I'm not sure how I'm feeling about the purple. I like it. I think it looks good and it does match my room. However, my dad was saying we could do like a gray, which I think would match even better and kind of look more chic and sophisticated and adult like. I feel like the purple, I think the shade of it is just not what I'm looking for. I think if it was maybe like a darker purple, it would look better. So I'm not sure. I think we might do the gray, but this is the update for right now. It's been a while since I've actually worked on this mirror, and that is because, as you guys saw from the previous clip, I accidentally, or not us, but the mirror had accidentally gotten cracked when we had put the cardboard in it so that it wouldn't we wouldn't get paint on the mirror. So my dad had to literally get an entirely new mirror to put inside of this one. Once again, the purpose of me doing this is because I love this mirror so much. I think it's so unique and just beautiful. I've never seen a mirror that has opened up like this. It's kind of like, I don't know, it reminds me of something I would see in like a Disney movie. It's like kind of enchanted because of the design and how it opens up like that. And I didn't want to get rid of it. I just no longer liked the pink and the purple. You know, it was part of my old bed set and it's no longer. So once again, instead of buying a new mirror, I wanted to refurbish this one. But yeah, so I'm so happy because I now have a brand new mirror and I can start painting this color. So this is actually the next step in the transformation process. I went to go put the mirror down and look what just came on. Ah! Oh my god, what do I do? All right, you guys, I had to kill the bug. As I was saying, at first I wasn't sure what color to paint this. I was gonna keep the purple. However, after putting it together, I didn't like it. So what I'm gonna do is I was gonna do white, but then I forgot that I still have some leftover paint from my room, which is kind of like the bluish. It's actually gray, but it kind of looks blue. So I'm gonna paint this the gray color. That way it matches my room. And even in the future, if I ever were to change the design of my room, it would match because it's neutral colors. For anyone wondering, this is what the paint looks like. It looks blue, but it's actually gray. After mixing it, it's now looking a lot less blue and more of a gray. I love this color. I think it's so pretty, and I think it'll look really good with the white. Worst comes to worst, if I don't like it, I'll just do white, but I'm hoping that this looks good. I feel like it'll be nice contrast. Yeah, so I think this is good. Let's start painting. Coat. The reason why it took me a little bit extra longer is because I forgot that there's like gaps in between the mirror, so I had to go in with the little brush to get those gaps. It's been about an hour and a half. I just touched it and it is dry, so I'm gonna quickly do another coat of paint on this side. I'll show you guys after. I'm not gonna do another montage because I'm just gonna do it really quick, and I'll show you guys what it looks like after. The second coat is done. It looks so good. As you can see, the first coat, it was obviously very streaky, but after letting it dry and doing another coat, it looks a lot better. Yeah, so I'm gonna do the other side tomorrow, and then what I'm gonna do is the leftover purple here, I'm gonna paint that white, so I will also do that tomorrow. But as of today, I'm done. It's the next day, and when I went to go flip it over to do the other side, the paper had stuck to it, so I'm trying to take it off. That's what all of these little pieces are, so I'm gonna move upstairs and do it on a rag instead so that this doesn't stick to my mirror. Did the other side of the two parts of the mirror. As you can see, this is just one coat, so I'm gonna come back in an hour to do another coat. I was trying to be very careful so that the paint didn't drip in the cracks. That's what ended up having the paper stick to the mirror because of the paint that was wet and dripping. But yeah, so I'm gonna come back in an hour because this paint kind of dries fast, and yeah. is the back of my mirror. The mirror is, this is the front of it, and then this is the back. So I just finished painting the inside. I did 3 coats, and I did 2 on the first side last night with the white paint. Right now, as you could see, this was the before with all the purple, and this is the after. So I still have to do another coat. I'm gonna wait for it to dry, but I'm gonna start working on this side. The mirror is finally done! Oh my god, I am so excited and happy right now. It looks so good. Also, if you're wondering about this, it got broken a very, very long time ago, so it's just gonna stay like that. I don't really mind it. And yeah, so this is the finished product. I'll do a before and after in the morning, but this is the finished product, you guys.